What's going on, guys?
What's up, y'all?
What you been into? We're a warm one today, huh?
Man, I know, dude. It's just so humid. It's just extremely...
Well, it's kind of...
I'm not bitching and moaning because we're going to be 3 months now. People will be freezing.
That's what I say. When people complain about the summer, but yeah.
Just wait a little while.
I'll remember this day when I'm scraping out.
Exactly.
Yeah. So
I'm investing my hard-earned money just to try to get a glove with the thing on it, so that you know what I'm saying.
Yeah.
The days where I don't have to bundle up like the little kid from that movie, you know, where the Christmas Story.
Yep, he couldn't put his arms around.
Just to smoke a cigarette, you know. Now I can walk outside in flip-flops and shorts and just on the balcony and smoke a cigarette. And three or 4 months from now, I'm gonna be like. Wearing a mask, you know, the wind whipping across.
Yeah, that or smoking less.
Exactly. Oh, I smoke less in winter. Cause
did you get anything done today, or?
Yeah, somewhat, man. I just,
what does that mean?
Well, rearranging the front.
And then
Carmen's home, so I'm helping her. We're moving all of her stuff out. We're redoing her stuff. I'm redoing, putting my room into another room. Sitting room a legitimate sitting room.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? We're getting the drum kit. I'm going to get it cleaned up and everything. I told her to keep putting stuff on it, get those tuned up, and make the attic a true music room like we did before, because I want to get a keyboard for it. You know, and then like my mom's seashells, I put that tier together, so I'm getting her conch shells and her over the years that she's collected and bought and whatever on display, because it's nice. Yeah, she was out of it, y'all. She went this morning to have a tooth pulled, like a pretty big tooth. Now this is a woman who gets the prescription for the hypnotic for a tooth cleaning, basically. So she was out of it before and after. Like my dad calls, tells Carmen, get your old lady, you gotta help get your ma in.
Oh, no.
So I was basically, she took one beforehand. I said, if you can never have to do that again, or at least wait until on the way, because she let it take effect. I literally had to put her in a office seat and move her out down the ramp.
What did she take, a Valium or what?
No, this is labeled a hypnotic. It's beyond that. This is like your roofie type medication. You know the roofie where it knocks people out?
Right.
Like we're hypnotic and stuff. It's classified a hypnotic. I looked it up last year when she got one time. And mom's like, look, Eddie, they only prescribe it like one at a time. They never prescribe more than two.
Right.
Because like, it's what you creepers would want. Like, it just knocks people out. Yeah.
Is it better than a Mexican quaalude?
Oh my God. She don't remember 10 hours of that day. She was getting ready, talking about how hungry she was, and she wasn't going to get to eat, and she hoped that it didn't hurt.
Right.
And she's taking her pill, and 10 minutes later, she's.
Wow.
Yeah. Cayete por favor, quiet, please. Shut up, please, because there's.
Crazy,
I need to make sure she's still breathing. Yeah.
Wow.
She woke up at like 5 or 6 that night and talking about, I wish I were having her get it together. She always reverts to that, like she did today. Like, y'all get it together, so y'all can take me to this doctor and get this done.
Yeah,
we did 12 hours ago, Ma.
Right,
Now they brought her home with this ice pack and all kinds of stuff. Carmen's like, she felt bad because she can't.
Did you get a wisdom tooth?
Yeah, something like that, yeah. And she's older, Plus she's diabetic, so he'll do it with RA and all that. Her bones are like weird anyway. So she can't take a pain medicine until like 2 o'clock today because it would go affect with the. That would be bad, so she had to wait. But she did all right. She took a Tylenol. She'll take something, I'm sure, by now. So.
I had like 3 wisdom teeth more when I was in the 20s.
They do a good job on it. Yeah.
So what's up in the morning?
Not sure, man. I'm hoping it's going to be cloudy like it was today so I can get the rest of my yard work done, because I'm going to get the yard looking good for just coming up, especially when they live, you know, so. And then Friday they play at Micaiah's. You're bailing on me up here.
No, I got to work at Mr. Krabs Saturday.
Oh, for the love of Pete.
Well, I have to do something. Yeah.
So how was your day?
Huh?
How was your day?
I was good, yeah.
Yeah? Geared up. I heard you got a big day tomorrow, I heard.
What's tomorrow?
I don't know. It worked, I guess. You said you had something coming in on Thursday.
Thursday or Friday. No.
Yeah, I wrote about Ronnie. He said, good God, he going to be looking at it. And I was with my backpack on. I'm headed up there. He's the one that called them in. Uh-huh. And I heard that guy say, can I borrow your vacuum cleaner? Ronnie said, good God, that's all right, Mr. Hooper calling.
Yeah.
You be careful on that bike now. That's what he said. Man, I will call you. And he looked at me like he was like, that had beat him in the ass.
Right, because
Tony
was up there.
I mean, I don't necessarily think, I think it was something he done, or, you know, just whatever. Yeah, I'm like missed some stuff. You know what I mean? Yeah. Between the thrice
that,
of them.
Who did that, Tony? Or?
I don't know which one done it. I just know the three of them was up there today.
Oh, Tony
Fitz? Tony Fitz, and yeah. You see, why did he call me in? That's what he tried to do yesterday. And then he claims that before I could even, I actually went to the shop quicker than I could have called him back and him answer.
Yeah.
Literally. And when I got there, he's like, I ain't gonna believe it. Sitting at the door, it was locked. And then he looked out, he went, I heard him, good God.
Yep.
And the other door, he's man, you ain't gonna believe it. Lord, you'll be mad. I said, what? I'm sweating. I'm like, what, you called me? I'm coming up. He said, man, Tony, I don't know why, but I called Tony whenever I called you. And before you even knocked on the door, Tony just called. And he said, man, he's working. I said, man. And he said, sit down. He said, do a cool down. And he pumped the tire up, you know, yesterday. And with all that happened, he's like, so I come by there today. This afternoon just to see how it went. In your plate. And as I go by to see how it went, he's like, he was looking over that car. And then he went to come back in. I said, what was he doing? He's like, this guy, he's about to pull up. I'm afraid he's gonna say something. I said, well, if you're afraid he's gonna say something, let's fix it real quick. No, you're on the way. He pulled up right then. Sure enough, his wife dropped him off. Yeah. He asked for, as I was leaving, I heard him ask for the vacuum cleaner. He wanted the wheels redone, and you know, a couple other things. Yeah. And I'm looking back like, yup, I stopped by to check. Yeah. So, that's how the day went. I ain't say nothing.
Yeah.
Actions speak louder than words. Harmonicus is good in this.
Oh, yes.
Steppenwolf's not credited as much to have a good harmonica. But,
oh, John King.
Yeah, that's good.
Yeah.
Like somewhere in Louisiana in the Baton Rouge, be a Baptist preacher, and that'd be one of the hymn, the church choir song. 40 days!
Oh, yeah.
And I said, now 40 nights. You know how they sing the sermons and that?
Of course they do. That's pretty wild. Yeah, I get a kick out of that.
Yeah, man.
I hope she calls back home tonight. Any Rollins in the wrong part. Yeah.
Their songs had a lot of depth to them.
Oh, yeah, they're good.
They had a lot of depth.
They're from Germany. And then, like I say, it's number 7.
Oh, yeah. And the crazy thing is, they sound like they're from the bayou somewhere. That they probably grew up next to the Fogerty brothers, and they're from different continents, and neither one of them grew up in the bayou.
Right.
So,
yeah.
It just goes to show you that music can just.
Yeah. And then, you know.
And same with the Doors.
Well, yeah, because previously they used, on the first record, a couple Steppenwolf songs on Easy Rider.
Sure.
But, this is the 7th record.
Who had told me the other day that somebody had performed at Woodstock, but they didn't want to be filmed?
Oh, boy.
Who was that? It was on the ride, I heard it.
Right.
I'm thinking back. They did a great performance at Woodstock.
Repeat the question.
There was an iconic band that played at Woodstock, group, but yet, even though they did a great job, they didn't want it filmed. There's audio, but there's no film of it. Yep, and in retrospect, they wish now they had had audio of it. But I can't remember the name of the band.
I know, I read it somewhere in one of those anniversaries.
Right.
About Woodstock.
Yep.
I can't remember.
That's turned out to be a disaster, the 50th anniversary. It's now moved to Arkansas or somewhere, I don't know, somewhere in maybe upper New York. New York's out of the question for right now.
What?
Oh, yeah.
Well, they might as well not have it.
It is a disaster. You can't replicate some things,
right,
man.
Yeah.
Even to honor it. You can't have a coming together like that.
Yeah.
You don't replicate greatness. Greatness just happens. What are you looking for? What'd you lose, you pacifier?
Talking to anybody?
No, man.
Well,
why would I ever do that?
Well, because you have in the past.
No.
Yeah. So what are you going to do with that big old hunk of concrete?
I don't know.
You
know,
like clothes line.
I don't know.
You dug a crater.
Nope. Like an archaeology discovery. I told you, the neighbor's little kid said, what are you doing? I said, burying a body. Keep asking questions, bub.
Well,
yeah, after sweating like crazy, that's me.
Yeah.
What's he doing? What's he doing?
Well,
I just...
How deep down did he...
I'm 3.5 feet down so far, and there's still...
What? There's still concrete?
Yes. I'm talking about, you got a troubleshooter. I went way to the bottom.
Dude,
and I've been digging like an arc. And I can rock maybe a 16th of an inch.
Right.
Move that way, this way. So I still got another foot and a half. So I just need to like get a sledgehammer and just knock the top of this damn thing off,
right,
break it down.
Right.
The problem is you got a pole in the middle of it.
Right.
So I got to try to get that pole bent out of it too.
Well, once your chip went to the concrete, the cement, you know, that thing will pull like a paper napkin.
Right.
Like I say, man.
But the pole's just only above.
Well, Christ,
what I'm saying, the pole didn't cut off this much above his stuff. So.
He must have done at least 4 feet down.
Oh, yeah, we did one.
He probably had a post hole digger.
Oh, yeah.
And just put the sink of the rod.
When my grandpa's cement. When they built stuff, they did it. Could have been my dad's brother, Bruce.
Because
when Bruce did something, it lasted for life like that. All that woodwork around the unit we have, he did all that. You know, Bruce passed away, but he did it. And my grandpa was the same way, you know, but.
Yeah. It's a good song. This is song R.I.P. record, which was Grace Hitch. 69, 72.
Right.
Now the organist, John.
He's great. I mean, Magic Carpet Ride intro. You see them live in the 80s? I mean, he's in his 70s now, actually.
Right.
But in the 80s, mid-80s, early 90s, you see them at these fairgrounds and the other places, these Palladiums, you do these concerts.
Yeah.
They rock, dude. They did audio
on it. Well, he has a good voice.
It's got like 4, 5, 10, 15. Yeah, he does, man.
Yeah.
Like, and the band was always tight. He's got a great voice.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? They had depth to their songs.
Yeah.
It's like a more rock version of sometimes a Gordon Lightfoot. Does that make sense?
I think we played Monster.
Yes, we did. This is the second one.
No.
Or even third one.
We played Monster.
We've done quite a few steps.
We played Monster, then we played the first one, and this is the third one.
Right.
It's actually step in 7, but.
But how do you feel about that comparison? They would be like, if I had to describe, I'd say, take a Gordon Lightfoot with a heavier Gordon guitar. With complicated, you know, this would be like.
What, step?
Yeah.
Oh, well, they have the organ.
Sure.
Like the Doors.
Oh, yeah.
Psychedelic.
They've always been all of that, yeah.
Okay.
From 67 on.
But the thing was, though, the first couple of self-knowledge.
Yeah.
They used two songs from the Easy Rider. So they were labeled as like a biker band.
Right.
Yeah.
Right.
Good music.
And John K played to that, so, you know, with the leather and all, you know what I'm saying? But hey, I mean, it appealed to the masses anyway. It just crossed over everywhere from like Carpet Ride. I mean, they had better stuff than that, but Top 40 they crossed over, so that helped also.
You know, this guy takes off on guitar.
Oh, yeah, they jam, dude. They're a great jam band.
That can
play. Probably 69.
70.
Oh, I was off. I was close though.
Right.
There's somebody born in 75. I'm pretty good on my knowledge.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Sledgehammer just to knock the head out of the top of it.
Yeah.
A couple good times, good come out.
Right.
I'm working with almost a ball peen hammer here. You know what I'm saying? Dad's not known to have a big hammer.
Yeah.
You know, yeah. He gets what you get out of a little set. You know what I'm saying? That's,
I know, man.
Right, right.
You know.
Couldn't imagine what I'm like.
It's
like Tycho. It's one HBO of Tycho toy set.
Carpenter's.
Plastic nails.
But listen right here what it says.
Tonight's a black moon.
Yeah.
Yeah, man. Tonight's a black moon.
Oh, no, is it?
Yes, it is. I might have to look up Sam the Sham.
I know, but
you
know what?
Yeah, I like this song, man.
Yeah, all this shit. call in August. My birthday's in August.
My dad.
Well,
whose birthday?
Oh, I don't know.
Who?
August 20th, Wildman.
Oh, Michael. Yeah. Okay.
Yeah.
Well, Dana had mentioned the other day it was in August. That's
yeah,
right.
Right. Yeah.
Yeah. This is the song I got wrote on a card, Steve, that I found random in my wallet after Dark Cherry. And I looked it up because I liked it so much.
Yeah.
From this album.
Oh, yeah.
So we've obviously played this album but not recorded it. Because I like this song.
And then there's Eddie Rollins on the harmonica.
Ladies and gentlemen.
Play a clean harmonica.
Man.
Well,
I'm not. Why do you gotta make fun of how the musicians call it sound?
Well, this sounds good, man.
This is called, this is, and it's a blues mic.
Yep,
this is called a dirty mic.
That's
it's slang
yeah,
for
so,
black people called it a dirty mic.
Yeah,
so
I
it's blues.
Right, yeah.
Yeah.
Oh,
well. And that's what we call it. We call it a dirty mic. It's clean like that, but it's referred to as a dirty mic.
ABBA.
We don't want to hear ABBA.
Why? ABBA?
I heard you say ABBA.
I'm like, oh.
If I ever rolled up over here on a bike and heard Dancing Queen going on from an ABBA album, I'm not getting off the bike. I'm just rolling the whole bag on. I'm not.
The
I'm
one,
out.
No, the one that I like, you know, it's like, it's an episode of Simpsons. And Mr. what's his name? Smithers, play my victory music. I was like, Waterloo!
Oh my God, like, Waterloo, right.
Yeah, but then Smithers says, I'm sorry, sir, I picked over,
Right.
Stars and Trappers
forever, but yeah.
I was like, Waterloo!
They were actually at a press conference on, ABBA was on tour.
They were very popular.
In the heyday. This was the heyday.
Well,
they made a fortune. Right, so they're on tour.
But they have not reunited.
No, of course not. They're on tour. This is the heyday. They had stopped off somewhere in the UK at the tour.
Yeah.
And they were in a press conference. They were surrounded by press. They had swarms of people.
Right.
And this UK British reporter stands up and says, he talks to that one blonde, the lead singer, younger blonde.
Yeah.
You know, he's like, well, they say you have the best arse in all of rock and roll. Is
that
true?
Oh, wow.
Do you have the best arse in all of rock
that's
and roll? And she turns
personal.
Around and like pokes her ass out. And she's like, well, I don't know. In her sweetest voice, whatever.
Right. Yeah,
like, I don't know. You be the judge. And they claim that she had the nicest ass in rock and roll.
Well, I mean,
in that era. In that era.
No. Well, this is a good song. My friend Kevin.
How can you go from talking about her ass to...
No, but this is a cool song. You know, it's like, hey, you listen to the lyrics, but he only had a dollar to live on till next Monday. But he spent it all comfort for his mind.
Well,
listen. Lying on the pavement. He has a good voice.
He had a great voice. The only other voice closest to his baritone, the way he sings, is Gordon Lightfoot. Listen to me.
What? Okay.
They sound alike.
You're right.
They do. And I'm not saying it in a bad way. I think it's great.
No,
how it crosses the tides of...
Right, you make sense.
Yeah. That's why I was saying it's like, imagine Gordon Lightfoot's voice with the with the organ and, and with, with Goldie on, know, and with all the musicians.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
That's how I would describe them if they never heard Step Away. But if they had Gordon Lightfoot.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? But, and the vice versa, with, I'd say, you ever heard John Cage's voice from Steppenwolf? They said, yeah. I said, you never heard Gordon Lightfoot? They said, nope. I said, well, imagine John Cage without all of the other stuff, and it'd be, you know, a folk version. That's it.
One of us, there'd always be a problem. Just born was a mother.
The drudgery.
What duh? On an airline made of snow. It's called Snow Black Prince. Singing songs that can fly. Flying low. Dancing. this is the first song on side two of this record.
It's great, man. Oh, yeah. It was recorded very well.
Well, because this was not one of the greatest hits.
His voice is, his audio is crisp, the guitar is crisp, and the bass and the drums are very crisp. That snare is tight. You gotta make that snare a crisp sound to give it a pop.
Right.
But the band's gotta be good and the voice has gotta be good. You can't hide nothing with this.
No. He knows the honest truth was, you know, like when I was like in the TGY or the Rexall drug store, that little record rack, you know, and then you can pick up it was the cutout bin for like 99 cents.
Really?
Well, if you read about it in the Rolling Stone record guy, they talk about the cutout bin and how the records went through the record rack, you know.
It's just one more way for you to go through the selection of music that they were offering.
Dirt cheap,
at the last moment. If you're not going to buy it for what we're charging back here, what about this song for this price? You know, just one more shot at buying a product. Your last chance, obviously. Right. Save is anywhere. Yeah. That's where all your gum, candy bars, and batteries and stuff is called last chance.
Well, like I said, but you understand, you know, the introduction to it. You know, just like on Levels, you have that big book with the binder.
Sure.
Take pages in and out. It was constantly changing.
Yeah.
The music. Oh, yeah.
Yeah, man.
Oh, yeah. And it was like the best thing to do.
Yeah.
I mean, interesting to find one of those, just for that. Yeah. Because they had all the record numbers and all that.
Oh, I'm sure it's out there somewhere.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. You can find some like American Pickers, man. Those guys, that's what I miss about going on with Mr. and Mrs. Grimes. Either watch American Pickers or the Eating Guy.
Oh, the one bald-headed guy that eats weird food?
Well, he's got the blonde hair, it's kind of spiky hair.
Oh, Guy Fieri.
Yeah, and then he drives a Camaro.
Right, Guy Fieri.
Yeah. Find me standing in my boots, kicking Ralphie around.
Kicking Ralphie around.
Look low enough to build a blonde. Oh, that sounds like Johnny was around here. Came about down the road.
Yeah. And you would never know they were from Germany.
Right. And then when I was in grade school, I used to own these books. It was like a scholastic book. It was like, it was questions and answers about music. And then they asked, the question was, what are your real names? And then John K was something, you know.
There's your word for something.
Right.
Yeah.
Go let me John.
Right.
But yeah, because they're pure German.
Wow.
Yeah.
Wow. That's amazing.
Yeah, and then, like I said, they escaped from World War II.
Okay.
So they, you know, they saw
it. Yeah, because if he's alive now, and I'm sure he is, but last time I checked, he was a couple years ago, he was like 71, 72, so he's, I don't know how many years ago that was, he's probably 75, 76 now, so, by God, he was rocking up to the 2000s, so.
He's probably pushing 80.
But Gordon Light, he's pushing 80, Gordon Lightfoot after a stroke and a coma for over a month and a half, and coming back and learning, he went back on tour, he was doing 300 shows a year.
Oh, yeah.
A year out of 350 days.
And we saw him at the Midnight Special.
Yeah.
Like, no, Gordon Lightfoot,
those guys are resilient, man. Like Neil Young, even.
Yeah.
You know?
No, because Gordon Lightfoot was. He was from up in
Canada.
Oh?
He was Canadian.
Right, and then anyone take my job? The record of Edmund Fitzgerald, they're crossing.
The Edmund Fitzgerald.
No, but they're crossing
the
Lake Ontario.
Yeah.
Right. Okay. Yeah.
And he did.
Right.
And once he did that song, Canada basically commissioned him to be their national artist spokesman.
Okay.
Yeah.
But listen, Eddie, listen. Listen, watch. Hang on. Watch.
All right. This
your watch, okay. Three. Listen. Two. 10. It took them 10 seconds.
To dial that
right
number. You'd already have been talking to somebody nowadays.
Today I have good news.
What?
I have bad news.
What?
Yes, the machine was getting last hour. But he tried to have
something.
Was no irony, was an ear splitting lung problem.
There was an episode of Combat. It was on Combat, they spoke German, and then he.
Well, I hope we didn't say anything bad.
No, but the thing is, but I picked up on like two words from that little.
Which were what?
I heard on Combat.
Oh, did you?
They said the same two words on Combat.
What was it?
Right. Or no, something like.
Do you know what it would have been interpreted as?
That's what I can't.
Oh my God! If I had Wi-Fi, I could just play that and it would interpret it for me.
Right. Oh yeah.
That way we'd know.
Because at one time at work, you know, we get these vests from Canada, you know, and then I found this little card and it was in French. And Aaron, he took his phone. Went from French to English.
Yeah.
I'm like, wow, that's pretty
cool. You just change it. It'll say at the bottom, you want to convert this to English?
Yeah, man.
Instead of from like right. Whatever.
French or whatever.
Exactly, anything.
Right. And that little card goes in. That's pretty wild. Yeah.
Walk up.
What do they think I'm next?
Walk up. I hit my app as I sit down in a foreign restaurant in France and I don't speak.
Yeah.
I don't speak French.
Right.
And the lady walks up and I take my order, and I say, I want something with steak, blah, 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 blah. And it converts back to her, and she agrees. And we set a price, so you don't need anything else.
And then she walks away thinking, damn tourist.
Well, are you going to learn a language where you're vacationing at for 3 weeks?
No, you're not.
Not fully. You might speak a few of them.
Oh, for the love of God, Eddie, just stay where they speak English.
No, I like to go. I want to travel.
Fruits on that, man.
Why fruits on that? I want to see everything in the United States. I want
to
travel.
Well, you haven't seen half the United States that I've seen. And I would love to go back to Mesa Verde, Colorado, man.
Well, I would love to go up west, but I've seen a lot of the United States.
What? On those John Wayne, you know, John Ford, Western.
I've been as far west as Texas.
Oh, boy.
I've been up the East Coast as far as
you can. Yeah, you ain't even put your puss in the Pacific Ocean.
Nope. Never. Never. I've been everywhere. Illinois. Missouri.
Right.
Louisiana.
That's
Kentucky. South. Alabama. Yeah,
Kentucky.
Louisiana.
Yeah.
I've been through, never been to,
Spain.
I've never been.
I've never been to Texas.
Oh, really? Yeah, I've been to Houston and I've been to Dallas.
Wyoming,
I went to the Dealey Plaza. I went to tour that while I was there.
Yeah.
So I went to the Dealey Plaza. Because as a kid, my dad and my grandfather lived in, right outside of D.C., so we would go see the Arlington Cemetery.
Yeah.
We'd go see the Eternal Flame. Johnny Kennedy's.
Yeah.
And so I told my buddy I went to Dallas. I said, well, as a kid I grew up visiting his burial. I like to see where he was killed at.
So we just
went down to Dealey Plaza.
Oh,
went by the school book depository and they have a monument
that
marks the area where he was shot.
Crazy.
You know, so.
Yeah, well, it's just like on that Joe Cocker. Yeah.
Jack Ruby, that's the name of the guy that shot.
Right.
What's his name? John was trying to think of that.
Right,
it took me 3 days to download.
Yeah, I know. Yeah.
But it came through, though.
Oh, yeah.
With no thought at all.
Yeah, man. Yeah. But we didn't post an episode.
No.
Well, we got mail.
Yeah, we got.
That was the.
We could have posted it.
Decades. Side two.
Oh, yeah.
A record two.
Not everything's feasible.
Right, but still. Oh, but again, by rain today, man, it's getting, I don't know, it's almost...
It said around 4 o'clock today when we were supposed to get thunderstorms, but
I don't know. Well, it's pretty near 6.
Yeah, it's running a little late today.
Yeah, man.
That storm had a flat tire. Oh, tar!
Yeah, tar. Yeah. Oh, let me think, what's up for Saturday?
I don't know, why?
Saturday night.
I don't know.
Well, they're going to show the Watkins Glen Bush race on NBC Saturday night.
Are you serious?
Yeah.
Maybe we...
because
the band plays Friday and Saturday.
Yeah.
Barring we get some rain, I don't know if I even need to mow. Like,
right.
As of right now, I have nothing to mow. It's driving me kind of crazy. I'm glad, but kind of not, because I like to keep up with it. It's looking ragged in places, but it's growing a little bit, but not nothing. I could, It's like a, when you go a high-pitched low note like that, it's kind of off-key. It's usually an inhale when you start out. Instead of blowing into the harmonica, you just inhale your first note. Last instrument changes like that, man. First note is an inhale. Which is odd. It's odd. It's not natural. I love the harmonica, man. Ronnie said, in the bed, he's up. When you ask Steve, I swear to God, this is a true statement, what I'm about to say. When you ask Steve, was the homeless bad before or after Donald Trump was in office?
Oh, no.
Did he
do that
in
California?
Did he do that in
California?
He asked me that about that today. He's trying to prove a point. He's arguing with somebody at church that the homeless people were bad before Trump. So that he can prove Trump's a good person.
Right, because that jail's waiting for him.
Oh, yes. He sent me that a little bit ago. I swear to God, Steve, God is my witness. So there, that confirms I'm telling the truth. He's Eddie. Oh, good God, before you go, ask him. Tell him. Well, ask him. My buddy, and he said whatever. He's like, me and we debate, kind of argue. He says that the only people was not bad before Donald Trump. I say that it was bad before Donald Trump. So ask Steve when he went up there if it was bad before or after. He'll know.
Okay.
Good God, make sure you tell, ask him. All right, now be careful on that bank. So that's right when I was leaving. He's trying to, a little justice. He don't give you the context of what the question's asking. Just wants you to say yes, so that he can use your confirmation to everybody he's a great friend.
Right, because sitting there, then, I get up and I go to the door. Oh, no, you can smoke in here. The door's open. Sure, that's so I'm smoking a cigarette, like, good God, Steve. I'm like, the homeless? I'm like,
he has the most random stuff in the world. And that's what makes him so great. Yes, he might have a naivete, however you pronounce it, to him about his... I shouldn't even say that, because if you ever watch it, it's not that, you know what I'm saying, it's regional. You know what I'm saying? So he has a view, determined view that was taught to him.
He
says he has two brothers. Oh, yeah, he does, San Francisco. He's got a niece that's a professor there at UCLA as a doctor for the doctor's degree. Right. She's a professor as a doctor. She's very, very talented.
He asked about Compton.
Did he ask? He just wanted to know.
Watchtower.
Good God, Ronnie. Good God, can I blend in? I mean, blood, can I like red?
The thing is, that's been always been the dark.
Right. You know, Watts and Thomas.
Inglewood. With the Lakers. Los Angeles Kings used to play.
You'd have preferred parking for $22, but then you have...
They had the same thing across from the Los Angeles Coliseum.
Not preferred parking, I'm just saying. I wish I had land like that. My family bought early days that a town grew up around where... Just the fact that you have a little strip of area, you make thousands off every month just to have it, because the cars park there. That'd be awesome. Yeah. Like, what would you think? Since they're going to work, they'd be riding to the store and riding by and seeing your little driveway area. Yep, it's full. So $500 a day.
I hope the car doesn't make any oil.
I'll clean it up. $500 a day, I'll clean it up.
That'd be a, Charlotte.
Good luck finding parking. I know. Like you said, good luck here in the future trying to get anywhere on Main Street anymore, much less anywhere near 77. Now it's Main Street. You've got all these influx of new apartments going up, from over there by Isabel's to everywhere. There's one up everywhere. And there's no infrastructure being built to accommodate them. It's crazy. groove, dude.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, as the song fades out, the record's over.
Yep.
Yep.
So song is over.
Yeah. Well, that's about the end of the show, then.
And if y'all didn't get to dance with anybody, that's your damn fault. So you should just got up and ask somebody. So, we're out.
We can do something tomorrow? Or, yeah, man.
Yeah, we'll do something tomorrow.
Or, either way, yeah.
All right, we're out, guys.
Later.